Have you been wondering how people take their audio files and turn them into transcriptions from their podcast? Well, today I'm going to show you exactly how you can do that using a software program that is Otter.ai. It is fantastic, and I cannot wait to walk you through step by step how we do this. So let's get right to it. Hey everyone, Crystal here, and today I'm going to walk you through the steps that you need to know in order to take your podcast files and turn them into text transcriptions. This has been something that has been a game changer for me. Not only does it help in creating YouTube videos just like this, but it also helps kind of just get more mileage out of my podcast content. It helps me take it from just connecting with my audience on an audio level to connecting with them in other ways. I can repurpose these transcripts for social media, or I can put them on my website for SEO purposes, or I can use it to create something that is free for my audience or even a paid resource. So let's dive right in to all the steps we need to take in order to transcribe your podcast. So step number one is obviously we have to record an audio file. Whenever I podcast, I use Audacity most of the time in order to create an actual file that I'm going to use for my podcast episodes. So you have to have an MP3 or a WAV file, whichever you prefer for your podcast. And you have to have that in order to be able to upload it for your podcast transcriptions. The second thing that you need to do is upload that audio file to Otter.ai. You can see exactly how I do this here. I'm gonna upload the file and then it's going to process. After some time, they notify me and they tell me, hey, your audio file is ready to go. So make sure that you have an MP3 or WAV, and this is kind of an extra bonus, you can actually use video files to transcribe the audio within your video. Super cool, right? I love this program. It's super easy to use, and I'm gonna dive into the other steps that we need to cover. But I want you to comment below this video and tell me, how are you planning to use your transcriptions? Are you wanting to use it to kind of give a bigger boost to your SEO on your podcast website? Are you wanting to have the resources for your listeners who are maybe hearing impaired and they still want to have this amazing nuggets of wisdom from you? How are you using your podcast transcripts? So make sure you comment below and tell us. Okay, let's get back to the steps. So this is the super cool thing about Otter.ai. So after we have created our audio file, we've uploaded it, the third thing that I want you to do is make any changes that you need to make. So whenever I am doing my podcast transcriptions, I'll upload my audio file and then I can see everything on the screen. If it is just me talking, you will see breaks in the text and it's not really formatted in a way that I could just download it and use it immediately. Most of the time, my name is misspelled because I spell it with a K and not with a C. And my last name is Profit with two F's and two T's. So I'll have to go in and make those changes and I'll have to format it. But guys, other than a few little mistakes here and there, this system works amazing and it saves me so much time because a lot of the grammar is already corrected. And once you start using the program several times, my name is no longer misspelled. Most of the time it shows up as a K and my last name shows up with two F's and two T's because this is artificial intelligence. It gets smarter as it goes along. So I love this program so much because you can edit things and change things up. And as you keep going and uploading more files, it gets smarter. So even with my Texas accent, it can still delineate words and it gets smarter in knowing that, oh, well, she says y'all a lot and not you all, which is what some other programs have tried to smush things together. And, you know, it just, yeah, this works for me. I love it because it can read my super thick Texas accent. So if you have an accent, you're worried about that, don't worry, try out the program. I'm sure it'll work amazing for you too. Fourth step that you need to take is you need to export your file whenever it's totally done. So if you have made all the necessary changes and you're like, okay, this is good to go, go to the export option and you will be able to choose what kind of format you want to use for the exportation. Did I just make up a word? Is exportation a word? It sounds right, but I don't really know. So you want to make sure that it is in the proper format. That way you can use it. If you want to export it to a Google Doc and make any other changes or to a Word file, you can do that, or you can change it straight to a PDF and you have a document that is good to go, ready to share with your audience. And the last thing I want to share with you is I have a video coming up soon that is all about how you can use this podcast transcription to repurpose your content. You can get so much more mileage out of your podcast content than you really think. And I want to show you step by step how you can use this to really promote and market your podcast, because you spend all this time creating this amazing show. I want to make sure that it gets in front of as many people as possible. So if you found value in this video, make sure you hit that thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe below. That way you're notified every time we put out brand new podcasting videos every single Friday. Make sure that you sign up for the free podcast bootcamp, which you will find in the link below this video, and check out these other awesome videos that I have worked so hard from all the people in the podcast community, the questions that they ask, and the things that I see my students and my clients struggling with, you can find in these videos. But remember, keep it up. We all have to start somewhere.